President Siusha Surendranagar. I'm here to present a paper on a study of vitamin D level in patients presented with acute coronary syndrome. The aims and objectives of paper is to assess the level of vitamin D in patient with acute coronary syndrome, to evaluate a possible correlation between the level of vitamin D in patient with acute coronary syndrome. The study method is, the study design is prospective study. Sample size have taken 50 patients in Siusha Medical College, Surendranagar, with acute coronary syndrome. Inclusion criteria were patients above 18 years of age and all patients with ACS event. Exclusion criteria, patient who were known case of vitamin D deficiency on vitamin D supplements and cases of renal deficiency, pregnant women, they were excluded on the paper. The result of types of ACS, the interval MI, the frequency was 20 with percentage of 40%. With inferior wall MI, the frequency was 10% and percentage was 20%. In normal patient with deficiency vitamin, it was frequency 11 and percentage was 22%. On NSTEMI, frequency was 9 and percentage was 18%. So total with vitamin D deficiency, the patient was 50 and percentage was 100 taken. The level of vitamin D in patients with interval MI less than 20 nanogram per ml is 11 patients. Then 20 to 30 nanogram per ml, there were 6 patients, and more than 30, there were 3 patients. With inferior MI less than 20, there were 6 patients, and 20 to 30, there were 3, and more than 30 there were 1 patient. With normal, in normal patients, with less than 20, there were 5 patients, to 20 to 30, there were 4 patients, and more than 31. NSTEMI, there were less than 90, less than 20, there were 5 patients, 20 to 30, there were 3, and more than 30, there were 2 patients. So total about less than 20 nanogram per ml, there were 27 patients having vitamin D level deficiency, and 20 to 30, there were 16, and more than 30, there were 7 patients.
So how will you interpret this slide in general? As slide ma, how will you interpret? Because 7 minutes na bolwan hoy to, how will you interpret?
Ma'am, with
highlights only?
The less than 20, there were 11 patients with interval.
More patients.
More one, vitamin D deficiency. So vitamin D deficiency was seen in 86% of patients with acute coronary syndrome, 16, around 32% patient having vitamin D deficiency level 20 to 30, and 27 patient, 54% patient have vitamin D deficiency less than 20. So the low 25 hydroxy level vitamin D, they were less than 15 as compared to level 13 or more than 30. Were independently associated with twice the risk of incident of MI and a higher risk of incident cardiovascular event, including the fatal and non-fatal stroke. And the conclusion about the paper is maintaining an optimal vitamin D level is important not only for calcium homeostasis, but also for cardiovascular risk, blood pressure control, and prevalence of stroke, metabolic syndrome, and peripheral arterial disease. Observational data support the link between the vitamin D status and cardiovascular disease, and vitamin D deficiency can be considered as cardiovascular risk marker. Vitamin D exerts its cardiovascular effect by reducing the activity of renin-angiotensin system and aldosterone system, lowering the blood pressure values, and having an anti-inflammatory, anti-proliferative, and anti-hypertrophic, anti-fibrotic, anti-diabetic, and anti-thrombotic effect, and beneficial modulation of classical cardiovascular risk factors. Vitamin D deficiency is treatable and supplementation is inexpensive. Vitamin D could be combined with antihypertensive agents in order to control the blood pressure as a simple, inexpensive, important prophylactic